Hello, this is Haku Devine, and today we are going to be reading SCP-5054. If you like this video, please leave a like on the video, comment down below, and subscribe to the channel. Let's get right into this. Item number SCP-5054, Object Class Keter, Special Containment Procedures. Physical containment of SCP-5054 is irrelevant. Project's critical curtain is in place to modify public perceptions regarding the efficacy of nuclear explosions against organisms from the phylum Eldritch and similar fictional or metaphysical entities. The end goal of critical curtain is a widespread belief that nuclear devices are capable of killing such entities without consequence. Critical curtain consists of two major strategies for the implementation of this proposal. The first strategy of critical curtain is that media which affects Eldritch or similar entities as immune or unharmed by nuclear devices is to be censored to remove such elements. All such media is to be put out of print and replaced with versions which either do not mention the applicability of nuclear bombs against Eldritch organisms or does so in a manner favorable to the overall goals of critical curtain. The second element of critical curtain is that the new media is to be produced in which Eldritch organisms are harmed or killed by nuclear devices. Foundation embeds within the North American film industry are to sponsor content that portrays such an interaction in a manner favorable to critical curtain. Similar protocols are to take place in global book publishing markets and in other similar media markets. If the current goals of critical curtain are unsuccessful, information about the phylum Eldritch is to be disseminated to the mainstream scientific research. This is only to be done if critical curtain is unable to sufficiently influence public opinion through the influence of media, and would constitute a partial lifted veil scenario. A focus is to be made on such organisms' lack of inherent defenses against radiation or massive explosive forces, which would make them vulnerable to death following a nuclear explosion. Description: SCP-5054 is a sapient concept capable of modifying itself. Examples of past concepts that SCP-5054 has taken the form of. These have been verified to no longer carry the influence of SCP-5054. Are the bitter taste of watermelon, 6,711 miles above the sea, and the red American pine tree. Aside from other some self-modification, the main anomalous property of SCP-5054 is the control it asserts over sapient entities who know of it. Exposure to SCP-5054 from another person who is infected with SCP-5054 may cause the infection to spread over sapient entities. Curiously, SCP-5054 is only capable of affecting a set number of sapient entities at a given time. This number is not known exactly, but is believed to be between 300 and 400. If SCP-5054 infects a new entity above its limit, one entity already affected will completely forget SCP-5054. SCP-5054 affects conscious behavior, often involving long-term decision-making. For example, SCP-5054 may cause someone to quit their job and start their own business. Infected entities will justify their actions as being normal, even if the action does not align with their usual behavior. SCP-5054 refers to itself as P, or Mr. P. I will be calling it Mr. P from now on. The reason for this is unclear. History: the origin of Mr. P is unknown. Evidence suggests that the anomaly predates the Foundation. Prior to 1992, Mr. P did not compel infected entities to perform especially noteworthy actions. Research into this area has been suspended due to the impossibility of documenting all entities that have hosted Mr. P. Starting in 1992, Mr. P affected humans and began to take much more drastic actions, most notably, everyone infected civilians attempting to form the Idaho Defense Group, a task force dedicated to building anomalous weapons in the event of a hostile extraterrestrial incursion. See document for incident 5054 Delta for more information. As of critical curtain, Mr. P has reverted to being less active in regards to the anomalous. Additional notes. A reliable test to determine if a person is infected with Mr. P is to present them with two visually identical objects. One object should be laced with the cognitohazardous agent, which makes the viewer decide against it, while the other is to be kept mundane. Mr. P has demonstrated not only an immunity to cognitive hazards, but the inability to recognize them. In order to assure that Mr. P infected entities do not avoid a positive identification by luck, this test should be administered at least 10 times with different sets of objects. Mr. P has demonstrated knowledge of the Foundation, the Anomalous, and several groups of interest, as Mr. P refuses to infect their members. Sapience testing. Researcher note: some members of the research team have personally reclassified Mr. P as explained. Their theory is that Mr. P is simply a desire to change, and that the current method of testing can be explained as an immunity to cognitive hazards, which we have observed before. The fact that Mr. P seems to be more active as of late poses an opportunity to test this postulate. I've devised a method of communicating with Mr. P through its infected entities. The entities will be given a keyboard and asked to type whatever full sentences they like in addition. In order to send our communications to the entity, we can use some liminal techniques. See document 5054 Ninja, it doesn't exist, to embed messages into the subject's headspace. We haven't had a success with this method in the past, however, given and Mr. P's apparent new sense of urgency, this should produce more salient results and put any silly theories away for good. Interview log. SCP-5054 Research Team, SCP-5054, also known as Mr. P. This interview was conducted over the course of several weeks. Several SCP-5054 prospects were identified in course and participating in the procedures described above. Under the cover of a group of a new drug regimen for readability purposes, the weeks-long study is formatted as an interview log. Begin log. Hello, in front of you is the board. When we ask you a question, we need to reply to your response. Yes, I understand. Is this working? That's fine. Do you have a name we can call you? My name is P. Why are you talking to me? Over the aspects, you have been relatively benign. Now you seem to be trying to do something. You created the Idaho Defense Group and launched a rocket. Can you explain what you're doing? I'm trying to help you for once. What do you mean? I saw some pretty big monsters and they threatened my livelihood. I'm taking them out while I can, because you obviously won't. What kind of monsters? It's hard to describe. Large. Very, very large. Green tentacles that poke out from places. Multiple colors per pixel, like purple and white and blue, squished inwards. Also lots of eyes. At this point, Site-19 Command orders the research team to end communications due to suspected, now confirmed, instances of information classified above their clearance level. It is unknown how SCP-5054 discovered information regarding the Eldritch Phylum. Some instances of the Eldritch Phylum have been classified as SCP objects. Consult documentation for SCP-4804 and SCP-Redacted for known altered specimens. Personnel with Level 3 clearance may consult documentation for Operation Moonlight in-depth information. Although it is possible that Mr. P discovered Eldritch on its own, it is most likely that MSCP read data dumped from the partial SIPNet database leak on 1991-09-22, which is September 22nd. Containment priority for MSCP has been updated to red. Incident 5054 Delta. Preceding events. At this point, Mr. P had been evading complete containment for 2 years. Identifying and containing SCP-5054 affected indies proved difficult to the flexibility and contagiousness of SCP-5054. Several minor incidents had occurred up to this point, including the melting of Larry Bomb's Foundation personnel with the study of Eldritch, and the attempted of construction and development of a Scranton Reality Anchor in New York City. Description. Several entities affected by Mr. P worked together over the course of 3 months to assemble a Calvin and Wardsboro device. If properly constructed, this device would have been able to eliminate the entire population of the Order Octopodia and its close relatives. It is unknown how Mr. P discovered the mechanics of the Calvin and Wardsboro device. Several machine tools were found in the basement while her device was kept, presumably used in its construction. However, due to a misunderstanding of some of the secondary components of a functional cabin and Wardsboro device, it was only partially activated. It is estimated that over 300,000 octopoda casualties took place in the next 5 minutes, including many specimens in captivity. Personnel at the nearby Site 12 identified the source of the anomaly as a house in Orlando, Florida. All involved SCP-5054 positive entities surrendered themselves after being confronted by armed personnel. Due to the lack of close observation of octopoda specimens by certain circles, the cover was not released. The anomalous drop in octopoda population are given amnestics on a case-by-case basis. Critical condition below is considered classified by order of the project head and HMCL supervisor for SCP-5054. Being this document without level 3 clearance or valid T-1320 authorization is considered a breach from the contract. Punishable by expulsion from all Foundation duties and clearances. Project Critical Curtain and Progress. Ongoing. Overall success. Media featuring the Eldritch pylon being destroyed by nuclear weaponry is being continually reproduced and distributed. The defective documents suppressed. At 26 March 22nd, yes, Mr. P appears to have assisted from the optimal activity. In order to assert these results, Project Critical will remain in operation. Same priority for SCP-54 downgrade to green. Seminar transcript. Source. Researcher Calvin's seminar on new containment procedures for Mr. P. Date, 1996, April 3rd. Begin log. Good afternoon, research team. I hope everyone has a copy of the report for Incident 5054 Delta in your hands right now. You can't, what, you don't? The research assistant in front should have. Listen, I agree nothing in that report is above level 1 clearance, let alone level 3. I wouldn't let the research assistants handle it if it wasn't. Could you? Yes, just share it with the person next to you. Thank you. Anyways, report. You can see Mr. P, known informally as Mr. P. See SCP-5054, known informally as Mr. P, coerced numerous civilians into constructing a Wardsboro device. On the next page. Now the question puzzled me the most, as well as you, I presume, is Okay. Sir. Oh, wow, lost my spot. Sorry. For what we could tell from evidence, all evidence, Sir was trying to attack the Eldred Phylum. So why was he going after the octopi? I'm sorry, it's actually octopuses. Thank you, Dr. Idiots. Mr. P wasn't being cooperative in terms of containment, so interviewing it again was out of the question. After some time, we had an epiphany. No specimens of Eldritch, the ones we know about, look like octopuses. But by accident, we spread propaganda saying that they do. Hollywood has produced dozens of movies telling us that Cthulhu is a big-screen, scary octopus. They said something about Mr. P, too. Automatically, it's a standard cognitive hazard, just like you or me. It's affected by cultural means. Thus, we put our resources towards the cultural mean that does P. Hey, we've got this. We can eat Cthulhu. Don't worry about it. It turns out Mr. P's friend Eldritch are actually, truth be told, I think we have bigger problems. Wait. I can't actually look at Operation Moonlight. That's sad. Anyway, that was SCP-5054. If you like this video, please like on the video, comment down below, and subscribe to your channel. I have no idea what I'm going to be doing tomorrow, so until then, goodbye!